Tara, I'm hearing it even gets worse than this, that there potentially is out there, if you will, two sets of record among the upper echelon of the FBI, one that was real and one that was made for appearances. Is there any truth to this?
Absolutely, Sean. I think that right now, especially with the number of sources that I've been speaking with, as well as some others, that there is evidence indicating that the FBI had separate sets of books. And if that is the case, I mean, it certainly appears that this, as Greg has already stated over and over again, that there could be and there will be criminal charges pressed against people.
Well, so in other words, they're saying one thing publicly, but
the
real story, the real set of books is held privately among how many people are we talking about and how high up in the echelon of the DOJ FBI?
I think there are quite a few people, especially higher ups. I will not name names until all of the evidence is out there, but there were certain people above Peter Strzok and above Lisa Page that were aware of this. I also believe that there are people within the FBI that have actually turned on their former employers and are possibly even testifying and reporting what happened inside the FBI to both the Inspector General and possibly even a grand jury.
What, you know, Greg, I mean, that would then mean at that point that this is a coup, that this is an attempted, you know, look, I think we already know that there has been enormous amounts of effort, time, influence, and abuse of power. One, to allow their favored candidate get away from crimes that other Americans would never be exonerated from. Then we know that it all goes back to Hillary, you know, funneling money to Fusion GPS through the law firm, hiring a foreign national, which is Christopher Steele using Russian lies, putting together the dossier. Then we know that the dossier contents were spread before the election for the purpose of really indoctrinating and misinforming the American people to influence them and their voting decision, if that's not bad enough. And we know it was used as the basis for four FISA warrants against Carter Page, a Trump campaign associate, and all of the information presented to the court was that phony dossier and these phony manufactured press reports from the same sources. So basically, it is the dossier, and they never verified, never corroborated it. And then they also had a leak, media leak strategy. And Lisa Page said they didn't have any information of any collusion 9 months into the investigation. So they start leaking for the purpose of what? To get the special counsel, which we know Comey also did. And then it seems like now you got a group of people that think that they know better than the American people. And they've got two separate, you know, groups of books. One tells the truth and the other's for public consumption. That's a lie.
Well, if they have two separate books, then they're obstructing not only Congress, but they're obstructing justice. You know, this whole Trump-Russia investigation is a case study in how personal and political bias motivated the FBI and the Department of Justice to abuse their authority to target Trump, to spy on his campaign. They broke the law in the process. You know, as I explain in my book, The Russia Hoax, James Comey's FBI department guidelines were completely violated by him and McCabe and Strzok and Page. They never had the legal basis to launch the investigation. They had no probable cause, no evidence of crimes. They invented and exaggerated facts based almost entirely on a fabricated dossier that they knew was from a British spy who was not credible, and all they had to do was read it, and they would have said this is garbage. But they didn't care. They used it to frame Donald Trump, and that is a violation of multiple felony codes in the United States criminal code. All of these people who were involved in framing Trump need to be brought before a grand jury by a serious and legitimate prosecutor and be held accountable.
So what are we going to learn then? Let me ask Sarah first, then Greg, we'll get your take. What are we going to learn when the declassification takes place, the unredacted materials are released, and the American people see it, although I'm getting many sources telling me that the DOJ and FBI are trying to slow walk this and roll this out as absolutely slowly as possible, and even trying desperately to take out some damning information that is in them.
I think, Sean, in fact, I know what we're going to see is an extraordinary abuse of power, one that we have never seen the likes of in the history of our country, coming from officials within the FBI and the DOJ. There will be an enormous amount of exculpatory evidence that should have been turned over to the Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Court. And as for the slow rolling, I am hearing the same. But remember, this is a direct order from the President of the United States. He is asking for all of this information to be declassified. They are fighting him tooth and nail, to the point where John Brennan and others have literally come forward asking the agencies not to cooperate with the President's order that he has under his own authority. I can tell you this, that the people, my sources, who have seen these documents in full, who have the classification to look at these documents and have never divulged to me the classified portions of those documents, said there is nothing in those requests that would violate national security. The only reason why they are throwing temper tantrums at the DOJ, the FBI,
they're going to be exposed.
The intelligence community. Yeah.
They're going to be exposed. Well, what they're doing here by saying don't cooperate is they're really saying to create and precipitate a constitutional crisis. We'll take a quick break. We'll come back. We'll get Greg to answer that question on the other side. We'll also give you the title of